Good morning, my dear students. In the last two chapters, we had learned about the present tense and past tense. Now, I'm going to start with lesson number 8. In that, you will learn about the future tense. Lesson number 8, the future tense. What do you mean by the future tense? Words that show actions or a state of being are called verbs. Verbs that refer to future time are said to be in the future tense. Future tense have four forms. Simple future, future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous. Now first we see about the simple future tense. Has many forms. Will plus verb to express a promise, prediction, offer, an intention to do something or a decision at the time of speaking. Be going to verb plus to express what is likely to happen or to talk about a decision made before the moment of speaking. Be plus verb plus ing to express what we are definitely going to do or what is surely going to happen. For example, simple future tense. The mechanic is carrying two tires. He is going to change the tires on the car. See, we can use will plus verb plus be going to plus verb. He is going to change the tires. They will be here exactly at 7 p.m. In the bracket, the be is given. There's not a cloud in the sky. It will be another hot day. Now next, future continuous tense. What do you mean by the future continuous tense? It refers to an unfinished action or event that will be in progress at a time later than now. It is formed in this way: affirmative, negative, interrogative. Three examples: subject plus will be plus verb plus ing. In negative, subject plus will not be, negative will come not, plus verb plus ing. Interrogative means you have to make question sentence. So will plus, you have to start the question with will plus subject plus be plus verb plus ing. You have to separate will and be. The question will start with will. For example, will you be sleeping at 10 p.m.? No, I will not be sleeping at 10 p.m. Not and sleep, negative. Not is given. Sleep is the verb. Will not be plus verb plus ing. Don't call him at 6. He will be working then. Work. Will plus be plus verb work plus ing. Now next we go to the future perfect tense. The future perfect tense indicates then an action will have been completed or finished at some point in the future. The future perfect tense is formed in this way. You can see over here, children. Subject plus will have plus past participle. Example, we will have received the parcel by tomorrow. The negative form of the future perfect tense is formed in this way: subject plus will not have plus past participle. Example, he will not have reached school. Future perfect tense, you can see over here, the examples are given: will have plus past participle form of the verb. By tomorrow we will have left this place. Leave is the verb. Past participle form of the verb is left. We will have left this place. By next month we will have finished our exams. Finish, will plus have plus finished our exams.